फाइट हमारी होने वाली है नागालैंड के अलीजो लानामाए और इनके विरुद्ध हैं हरियाणा के राहुल थापा।
Ladies and gentlemen, up to the next fight. Make some noise for Alizo Lanamai.
Alizo Lanamai, all the way from TCA Nagaland. Tonight here at MFN, he's fighting in the featherweight division and will be taking on Rahul Thapa. John, I know you like Nagaland. You're a big TCA Nagaland fan. What do you expect tonight from Alizo Lanamai?
Guys, what I'm looking for and what I expect from them is for them to implement a very strategic game plan. We know Rahul Tharpa is coming in here with a purple belt. You know he's either going to want to control it against the cage or get it to the ground. I'm sure Coach K-Man has been working all of these things. I want to keep it on the feet, and I'm looking for a spectacular, just a spectacular fight.
जॉन अवीजो ने अभी तक दो बार एमएफएन में खेला है, दोनों ही बार ये जीते हैं और आज एमएफएन के मंच में इनकी तीसरी फाइट है।
I am so excited, guys. I am just so excited. These are my two favorite schools in all of India. We got Warriors Cove on one side, and we got TCA Nagaland. I can barely contain myself right now.
चलिए देखते हैं अवीजो लानामाए के कीज टू विक्ट्री। इनकी स्ट्राइकिंग काफी प्रिसाइज होनी चाहिए। He should be more into scrambling. He should showcase his scrambling ability. क्योंकि जैसे कि जॉन ने बताया, राहुल थापा जो जिट्सू में पर्पल बेल्ट हैं, पूरी कोशिश करेंगे ग्राउंड पे लेके जाने की। And being a Naga, he should go head hunting right here tonight at MFN.
Something Coach K-Man told me that he has instituted is a nutritionist. He has instituted a nutritionist and a strength and conditioning coach. And you can really see the proof in the pudding right here. Alizo Lanamai is ripped. He looks bigger than we've ever seen him before.
And his opponent making his way to the cage, Rahul Thapa.
Haryana ke Rahul Thapa. वापस आ गए हैं मैट्रिक्स फाइट नाइट पे और आज एमएफएन 12 के मंच पे ये भिड़ेंगे नागालैंड के अवीजो लानामाए से। थोड़ा बता दूं जॉन इनके बारे में, इन्होंने भी दो फाइट्स खेले हैं एमएफएन में एंड इज 2-0। दिस जेंटलमैन इज अ फिनिशर, ही इज एन एक्सट्रीमली गुड ग्रैपलर एंड ही नोस हाउ टू फिनिश क्विकली ऑन द ग्राउंड।
हिज लास्ट परफॉर्मेंस, he came in, took his opponent down, transitioned through him like a knife through butter, choked him out in the first round. Unbelievable performance. This fight could, it has the makings to be the fight of the night, guys.
बिल्कुल जॉन, आपने देखा मैट्रिक्स फाइट नाइट 11 में राहुल ने नागालैंड के और अवीजो के टीम में लॉकिंग पावर को फर्स्ट राउंड में सबमिट कर दिया था और आज चलिए देखी जाए इनकी कीज टू विक्ट्री। ही हैज अ टाइट टॉप गेम, फॉरवर्ड प्रेशर को रखना पड़ेगा और कोई स्पेस नहीं देनी पड़ेगी और इनकी जो स्ट्रेंथ है स्ट्राइकिंग और ग्रैपलिंग, इन्हें उनके बलबूते आज इस मैच को जीतना पड़ेगा। Both these gentlemen are 2-0 at MFN. They made their debut at MFN. And here tonight, this is the fight that we've been waiting for. Let's look at the tail of the tape. We've got Alizo Lanamai, 21 years of age, 178 centimeters in terms of height, weighing in 66.3 kgs. His style is MMA. On the other hand, we've got Rahul Thapa in the red corner, 28 years of age, 183 centimeters in terms of height, weighing in 65.7, and his style is also MMA.
Ladies and gentlemen, fighting out of the blue corner, his weight 66.3 kilograms. kilograms, representing Lanaman, give it up for Alvizo Lanaman! And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he weighed in at 65.7 kilograms, representing Hariya, the Green Dog, Rahul Thapa! Ladies and gentlemen, as the action begins, a referee for the fight, Ranjit.
Follow my instruction all the time. If I say stop, stop the fight. If you want to touch gloves, might be bonus.
Let's go, guys. Let's go.
Let's go, John and Gary. In fact, ye fight MFN 10 mein honi thi Dubai mein, but kuch karanon ki wajah se Rahul Thapa ka visa nahi laga, and we couldn't make this fight. But both these guys have been waiting for this fight, and the action begins.
I'm gonna have to stand up. Rahul Thapa, Mark, mixing it up right here. Avizo doing a good job utilizing that head to create space.
Good stage double. Nice defense.
Rahul ne do chaat mukke khaye aur seedhe ekdam takedown ke liye ghuse. Aur unhone Khabib ki tarah Avizo ki taangon ko jakad rakha hai.
This is where he's going to want to control. He's going to want to kind of shuffle the legs, but kind of lost it right there.
There's a lot of aggression between both these guys.
A lot of aggression.
Very interesting scramble going
on. Oh, he's got a hook in. Let's see if Avizo can get that other hook in here, guys. Oh, a body triangle.
बहुत ही खतरनाक position ले ली है अभी Avizo ने. काफी घातक साबित हो सकती है राहुल के लिए.
Body triangles are one of the most powerful holds that you can have for control. But Lanaman may want to switch it to the elbow. Well, now he's back to the outside. You always want to have the nose to the side pointing up. But you can flank somebody out, exactly what he's doing.
Bottom triangle. Body triangle mein Rahul ko jakad ke Avizo mukke pe mukke baja rahe hain.
You know, one thing I'm seeing here is Rahul is doing a very good job of staying calm in this position. He's in a very dangerous position, but he is composed. He's very composed.
He is very composed. One of his things he wants to do is get his shoulders to the ground, which is kind of what he's done right here. But he's definitely in, he could get mounted right here. Or scrambled right now. Nice. He's in a better position.
What a scramble, guys.
Guard's open right now for him to pass if he really wants to.
Avizo looking for that little arm bar there. All right.
Do whatever you want now. Take your time. Trying to kind of levitate him for a sweep, but Thapa is dropping his hips down right now, which is good. But this is where he could pass. Once again, the guard's fully open right now.
This is where Rahul Thapa is going to be very dangerous.
अभी तक अवीजो फाइट को डोमिनेट करते हुए राहुल को उन्होंने कंट्रोल कर रखा है उनका गार्ड खुला हुआ है
he was attempting to pass there but he followed him with the hips now the guard is closed so it's harder to pass right here but Thapa is on top where he still has that control has a head underneath the chin good control here The Lanaman does have him tied up, so he's completely nothing really there. And this is where things can get interesting. He can look for a pass right here. Thapa can look for a pass.
In speaking to them over in the past week, I said, what have you been working on specifically? And he said, I have been working on cage walking and getting off my back because I know inevitably I'm going to be there.
Which is what he just did an amazing job of walking up the cage. That's a skill of its own. People don't realize how important, especially in a cold area like this, you've got to learn how to cage walk.
Not a position you want to be with Rahul Thapa giving your back up here.
Definitely not. But you got to stay composed here. You got to stay smart, stay patient. This is where you're going to try to... Could be going for a double right here, has a head on the inside. Could switch to a single possibly.
Avizo doing a good job of controlling that wrist there.
Yeah, he's controlling the inside wrist, which is an interesting thing, and you can handle that. Now see how Singh is going to switch to the double, possibly to a single. Flip to a single, now you can switch back to a double. So that's what we call chain wrestling. Right? You're trying to chain things together that get you the goal that you need.
Rahul Thapa, yahan. Oh! Bahut hi badhiya takedown. Bahut hi technical. Aur yahan pe dobara koshish mein lage hain ki back mil jaye Avizo ki. Aur Avizo ne pair pakad rakhe the Rahul ke. Rahul again pushing him against the cage with a lot of forward pressure.
Back to a double. You're trying to pull him out. Pull him out. Land him on his butt and then try to secure the legs. Kind of what Khabib does, lace him up. So we call that lacing the leg right here. You're gonna take him down. Now you should try to lace the leg. Exactly what I just said. That he would try to pull him back or try to lace it up. But Avizo is good at getting back up. He's kind of good at getting his back up, and he wants to cage walk up there. There he is. He's trying to get back. But
what a good first round.
What an excellent round, rather.
Very technical. This is a very, very technical fight, guys.
And both these guys are hungry for quick action. Let's go. Look at the highlights. This is how the bout started. And yahan pe Rahul ne takedown lene ki koshish ki. Avizo ne bilkul bhi nahi lene diya. And yahan pe dekhiye kis prakar se Avizo ne body triangle ke zariye Rahul ko chakkar rakha tha aur punches pe punches mare. Yahan pe thoda Rahul ko advantage mili. And dekhiye kis prakar Avizo ko niche leke gaye. और ये दोबारा से राहुल अवीजो को नीचे लेके जाते हुए चलिए देखते हैं फर्स्ट राउंड के स्टैट्स। अवीजो ने 25 टोटल स्ट्राइक्स फेंके जिसमें से 12 पावर स्ट्राइक्स थे और राहुल ने 21 फेंके जिसमें से 8 पावर स्ट्राइक्स थे। यहाँ ग्राउंड कंट्रोल देखे तो ऑफकोर्स उस बॉडी ट्राइंगल की वजह से पूरे एक मिनट अवीजो ने राहुल को ग्राउंड पे कंट्रोल किया।
Beginning of the second round here, guys.
Yeah, so once again, you want to establish control. You want to bring those punches on the middle is what you're trying to dictate now. And that's how the fight started. That's something that both these guys were really good at. And where the fight really changed itself was up against the cage, was where the wrestling played a factor.
Yeah, and you know what? You want to talk about evolution. Both of these guys, Tharpa started off as just a jiu-jitsu guy. Avizo started off, oh, what a nice teeth right on the chin, guys.
This can be dangerous. But once again, Tharpa got to right there to the judo, right there to the wrestling.
Tharpa doing a good job of holding him against the cage here.
Yeah, and that wrist control is moving right to the double.
Right to the double.
Beautiful chain wrestling, right? Straight from the back, knows he's got to turn his back to the cage and wait for the double and insert himself right there.
And you know what? I don't worry about Rahul Tharpa burning out of this position because I know where Jimmy comes from and I know they train this all day, every day. Non-stop.
Well, it definitely shows because being able to chain stuff like this, how he is right now, the way he's able to go from one thing to another, back to the double, back to the side, having that inside hook right there with his leg, that's some high-level stuff. That's stuff that you got to drill in training to be able to execute it in the fight. That is constant, constant repetition.
Tharpa seems to have one hook in here going for the back of Avizo.
Yeah, so that's one of the things. He's controlling the hooks. He's hoping that he almost kind of bounces off the cage and he may jump the other one. I've seen people do it. Another thing you can do is drag it out. And this up right here.
This is such a technical fight, Gary.
It is. It's actually really nice. We try to cap kick, he right back with the 1-2. So they're all returning. They're both returning from the other guy. Whatever he throws, he's right there. 1-2, come back with a jab. Have something in the other guy's face.
And you know what? Tharpa started off as a jits guy. And now he's developed a boxing game. Avizo started off as a stand-up fighter. And now he's developing a wrestling game. I love to see the evolution of these guys.
See, I wouldn't have guessed that about Tharpa. Like his striking is amazing.
It is.
And Avizo, his wrestling defense and everything is amazing.
Both of these guys are putting their heart and soul out there in the middle of this cage. Nice, nice transition, guys.
beautiful defense right there, getting your hips back and we're back at the cage. That was beautiful defense also. As much as the shot was really good, he was able to get his hips back.
Man, these guys are profusely sweating here.
Profusely. That goes to show you the humidity.
It is so hot in here.
It is so hot in here. They're going to make weight once again by the end of this fight. But right here, what he would want to do is almost kind of switch, drop your level here, and you can get the double right here. You get underneath the kneecaps almost. He's kind of high up on the hips.
Almost like the Kamaru Usman.
Has good control with his hands behind the hips. You may try to pull him out here, but good control.
You know, unlike other people, I see a comfortability or comfort here with Hamza against the cage. He knows that if his back's against the cage, he's just going to walk back on it. And you're right, absolutely right. Carpa doing a great job of controlling Avizo's hips in this position.
Yeah, for Avizo, it is going to get tougher as it goes on. As you can see, they're profusely sweating. So being able to cage walk up, you need your back. You need some sort of grip of your back. But now we're later on in the round, and that becomes harder, which is why I think he's being held down so much easier in this one. Because he's trying to get up, but he's being pulled right back down.
He is, and you see them slipping around. You guys at home can see these guys are very sweaty right now.
He's trying to create some sort of separation so we can get the fight back through there.
He's going to be careful of these up kicks.
Yeah. But if the guy is standing,
looks like Tharpa has a cut right underneath his eyebrow on the left side. Got a little blood trickling here.
Right,
Tapa, right. In any serious spot, nothing that'll really kind of compromise anything for him. It's one of those things.
Avizo's going to need to be a little bit more active on the bottom here. He's going to need to get up, create some situations, create some space, get back to his feet.
And that becomes harder and harder as the round goes because of the sweat. It becomes more and more slippery, and it's harder and harder to get anything going once you're all just slippery. Because those first rounds are so key in the
What a round. What a good technical round.
Yeah, so something that we see right here is them setting it up and off. There's a lot of amazing counter striking right here. That up kick right there.
That up kick was beautiful.
I've been caught by one of those, and it is not fun to get it underneath your chin. These calf kicks, good defense coming right back down
great
with a
defense 1-2. Here.
Good reactive counter striking that's going on. And the wrestling that's been going on right here. The more slippery they got, the harder it got for Avizo to get up. But he was landing straight from the bottom. I think that's where the cut might have come in right there.
I again, do not envy the position of the judges if we go all three rounds here.
Of course. So the strikes, it seems like it's pretty even here with the clinch strike where Lalo has no clinch strikes in there. And then the ground strikes, it seems like Avizo is the one kind of controlling it a bit more. But it is anyone's game right now. We're going into the third, and this is a very interesting fight in that sense.
It's two.
Bilkul, Gary. Avizo ka pure domination second round mein. Aur hum teesre round ki taraf badhte hue. Aaj aisa lag raha hai ki Avizo apne teammate ka badla leke hi jayenge Rahul se.
Avizo going for the takedown here, guys.
That was slick.
Uh-oh.
Off to Avizo for that, because to have the pace it gone, the exhaustion they have, and to have it defended, it can mentally break you just for attempting it, but he's still after him. He's still controlling the middle right now.
Yahan pe Rahul thode se tired lag rahe hain.
It might have threw Lyle off just the attempt, even if it didn't land. It could be like, why is this guy trying to take me down?
Exactly. You know what, Avizo's hands are getting lower and lower. He's gonna need to get those up and respect Raul Tharpa in this position here.
But even Raul is kind of more standing still right here, and he's going for it again. Oh, straight into the
mouth. Oh no.
He has spread them all, get both hooks in.
Not both of the hooks, just one.
Yeah, he ended up getting one hook.
Avizo yahan pe thoda sochte hue apne corner ko sunte hue पे रियर नेकेड चोक लगाने की कोशिश की राहुल ने. क्या बढ़िया शतरंज का खेल चल रहा है यहाँ ग्राउंड पे.
Abizo is cutting out too. They're both got a cut yes. above their eyebrows. And
very swollen eye. Very swollen. It's the battle of the left eye here.
Definitely. Tapa is back to controlling the back here. And this is something he's very good at. Staying tight to the hip, keeping the grip tight to yourself. And this is where you'll see Abizo has to fight the hands. You'll see him. He's trying to create separation here because as long as Tapa keeps tight, he's not getting away. So he has to fight the inside grip when his hands are clasped together, which is what you're seeing here. He's trying to create some room in between. And it's really tough to do.
This is anyone's fight at this point. Tapa's doing a great job controlling this round.
Setting up the body lock, keeping him nailed down. Now, what Abizo wants to do is get his hand on the other side and try to get as close to the mat as he can so he can possibly spin out or defend anything that could be coming.
राहुल अपने कोच की बात सुनते हुए उन्होंने यहां पे बॉडी लॉक लगा रखा है. अबीजो एकदम फंसे हुए हैं उनके बॉडी लॉक में. But I think Gary, the good thing is that Abizo has Tapa's hands locked in there.
Yes, definitely. That's definitely important. Keeping that wrist control is a very important. Wrist control, leg control are two very important factors of jiu-jitsu, wrestling. You want to have that. So they always tell us, fight the wrist if you're caught in something, and if you're trying to get something offensive, you take the wrist. And that's what you're seeing here.
Tarpa doing a very good job of being patient here and not rushing into any dangerous position, considering how sweaty and tired they are at this point.
I think that's why he's doing it. Because they're so sweaty, he wants to be sure of that he has the position. He doesn't want to get into scrambles at this point because they're very slippery. He'll get out. So why do that? Keep good control. You're winning the fight. And boy, there we go.
He
could be closing
it. He's got wrist control.
He's got the forearm underneath the chin here. There you go. It's because of that slim frame right here. Beautiful escape.
What a scramble, guys. This is a very technical fight.
Very technical fight. He's got both hooks in once again. Now they're both back to their feet. But Tapa is right back to controlling him from the back. It seems like this is just something. It's his go-to.
You can definitely see that this eye of Abizo is really bothering him as he keeps reaching up and touching it.
And as soon as Abizo puts his back, he switches right to the double. As soon as Abizo starts getting out, he goes right back to the back. He's just going back between the two. There you go. He turns his back, goes right to the back again.
Rahul यहाँ बहुत शानदार गेम दिखाते हुए उन्होंने पूरा कंट्रोल कर रखा है अबीजो को. अबीजो को मौका नहीं दे रहे हैं निकलने का. जैसे ही अबीजो खड़ा होते हैं ये कोशिश करते हैं कि उनको एक टेकडाउन दिया जाए.
I think one of the biggest problems that Abizo is having right now is that he can't fight the wrist because the grasp. So he's just had issues with that, and then Tapa just keeps switching from that back to the double, back to the single. As soon as he turns his back again, he goes right back to the back. It's called chain wrestling. So you're just alternating, you're just connecting and reacting, and you steal the rounds basically. It's basically what he's doing right now.
Persistence. He's been persistent.
Very persistent.
Persistent in the game plan.
As soon as the Abizo tries to escape, he'll go right back to the back.
चंद सेकंड रह गए हैं इस फाइनल राउंड में. और ये मुकाबला यही खत्म. गैरी जॉन, बहुत कठिन होने वाला है जजेस के लिए ये डिसाइड करना कि ये बाउट कौन जीता है.
What a fight, guys.
Very technical fight. If you enjoy technique, you enjoy the technical side of MMA, you definitely appreciate what this fight showed.
बिल्कुल गैरी, बहुत सही बोला. बहुत टेक्निकल फाइट थी. और ये देखिए हम हाइलाइट्स पे देखते हैं. यहाँ पे एक दो तीन पंचेस अबीजो ने चढ़े और जैसे ही राहुल आगे बढ़े उन्होंने टेक डाउन ले लिया. बट राहुल डोमिनेंट पोजीशन में आ गए. राहुल ने काफ़ी कोशिश की, बॉडी लॉक भी लगाया, रियर नेकेड चोक लेने की भी कोशिश की. बट क्योंकि पसीना बहुत आ रहा है दोनों को, अबीजो स्क्रैम्बल आउट कर गए और यहाँ पे दोबारा कोशिश की राहुल ने कि रियर नेकेड चोक लग जाए. और ये देखिए क्या बढ़िया टेक डाउन था राहुल की तरफ से. और यहाँ पे मुक्के चलाते हुए राहुल. लेट्स लुक एट द डेटा, द फाइट डेटा सो फार ऑफ दिस एंटायर बाउट. brought to you by Fight Geek. Aviso threw in a total of 20 strikes compared to Rahul, who threw in 10. Clean strikes, Aviso dominated 25 against 2. And ground strikes again, 39 for Aviso and only 2 for Rahul.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of action, here we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Mayank scored the bout 29-28. Judge Yashpal scored the bout 30-27. Judge Abhishek scored the bout 29-28. Declaring the winner by unanimous decision, Rahul Thapa!
That guy was really strong. He was fucking strong. I was trying to take him down, but he was again and again getting back up again and again. So it was so frustrating. But still, I was able to hold him down for very long. I was able to make him tire. And most importantly, I was able to secure the win.
And tell us a little bit more about your training and everyone that's here to support you specially.
I would like to thank the whole team of MFN. The full team back at my gym, Warrioscope, Comeback Lab, and here to ma'am, Aisha Shroff and Krishna Shroff, ma'am, for giving me this opportunity to fight here. Thank you so much, ma'am.
And now seeing us so much that we're at MFN 12, it's only going to get bigger, badder, and meaner. Who do you want to fight next as it gets bigger and badder?
Anyone in this division, featherweight division, anyone. Anyone who is up to fight me, I'm ready. Let's go.
Well, big congratulations. And now moving on. Thank you, Rahul. Have a great one, the next one.